So hi everyone, welcome to the series of lectures on signals and systems. So in the last class we completed the introduction part on the Fourier transforms. So in the introduction, so I gave you two formulas. So one is the Fourier transform formula, another one is the inverse Fourier transform formula. So you can remember those two formulas because the Fourier transforms depends on those formulas only. So this is the representation. So this is your continuous time signal. So when you apply the Fourier transform on this continuous time signal, so you will get the frequency domain signal, which is your x of j omega. And if we apply the inverse Fourier transform on this frequency domain signal, so we will get the time domain signal. So this is your Fourier transform pair. This is your Fourier transform pair. Now how can we get the frequency domain signal? So using the Fourier transform formula. So integral minus infinity to plus infinity. Here the time domain signal is x of t e power minus j omega t so dt. So this is the formula used to represent the our time domain signal in terms of the frequency domain. So this is the Fourier transform formula. Now what is the inverse Fourier transform formula? So this is your x of t. So how can we obtain x of t? So integral minus infinity to plus infinity. Here is the frequency domain signal x of j omega e power j omega t into d omega. So this is the inverse Fourier transform of your x of j omega. So that will get the time domain signal. So these are two important formulas. So the entire CTFT, that is continuous time Fourier transform, depends on these two formulas. So using the two formulas, so already we completed I think three properties of the Fourier transform. So we'll discuss the properties later. I already uploaded the remaining properties, so in the free time you can watch those videos. So remaining we have almost 12 properties are there, 12 or 13 properties are there. So I'll upload all the properties. Up to the previous class we completed three properties. So you can learn the remaining properties using these two formulas by watching the videos. So in the next the important topic we are going to discuss in this class is so this is very very important topic. So based on this topic also the essay question is asking in our examination. This is the computation of the Fourier transform, computation of Fourier transform. So in the syllabus it is mentioned like this, the computation of Fourier transform. So or the Fourier transform of the standard signals. So we are going to find out the Fourier transform for some standard signals, for some standard signals, that is nothing but the computation of the Fourier transform. So in this class we are going to start this topic. So this topic name is the computation of the Fourier transform or the Fourier transform of standard signals. So in that the first one is, so the entire the computation process depends on these two formulas only. So in that the first signal we are going to consider is the unit impulse function, so which is our delta of t. So under the basic signals I explained this unit impulse signal. So this is our unit impulse signal, which is your basic signal, unit impulse signal. So this is your unit impulse signal. So I want to find out the Fourier transform of this unit impulse signal. So I want to find out the Fourier transform. Now what is the Fourier transform of delta of t? It is nothing but delta of j omega. So I want to find the delta of j omega. So the Fourier transform is a tool to convert the time domain signal into its frequency domain representation. So this is delta of j omega. So I want to find delta of j omega. So how can we find out the delta of j omega? So to find out the delta of j omega, you just use this formula, Fourier transform formula. So what is the Fourier transform of, So the time domain signal delta of t. So this is very very important. So the Fourier transform of your impulse function. How to calculate the Fourier transform of an impulse function? First you should know the impulse. So what is an impulse function? Delta of t. So how can you define the impulse function? So it is equal to 1 so at time t equal to 0, and it is equal to 0 other than time t equal to 0. This is your unit impulse function. So I already told you this unit impulse function in the classification of this in the standard signals concept. So this is your delta of t. So its value is 1 at time t equal to 0. So other than the time t equal to 0, its value is 0. This is your unit impulse function. So to find the Fourier transform of the unit impulse function, so you just use this formula. So your formula is nothing but integral minus infinity to plus infinity. Your time domain signal is here, delta of t. In the formula we have e power minus j omega t into dt. So previously we have here x of t is there. So in the place of x of t, now we have the unit impulse function, which is your delta of t. Unit impulse signal is represented by delta of t, and it is defined in this way: delta of t equal to 1 for time t equal to 0. So and it is 0 for time t is not equal to 0. So this is the graphical representation of the unit impulse signal. To find the Fourier transform of the unit impulse signal, so you just use this formula. How to calculate the Fourier transform of the time domain signal x of t? The Fourier transform of the time domain signal x of t is nothing but x of j omega. So that is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power minus j omega t dt. So in the place of x of t, I just substitute the impulse function, which is your delta of t. Now what is the value of this integration? What is the value of this integration? So this is the integration between minus infinity to plus infinity. Now if you observe, here your signal e power minus j omega t is multiplied by the impulse function. So whenever any signal is multiplied by the unit impulse function, so the we can get the value of this function only at time t equal to 0. So the reason is because the impulse function is defined only at time t equal to 0, only time t equal to 0. For time t less than 0, its value is 0. That means from minus infinity to 0, its value is 0. For time t is greater than 0, that means from 0 to infinity, so its value is also 0. So whenever you multiply any function with the impulse, any function with the impulse, so you should get the 0 value. You should get the 0 value except at time t equal to 0, except at the time t equal to 0. So at time t equal to 0 only we will get the value of the function. So now what is the integration value? We are going to integrate this entire function from minus infinity to plus infinity. But from minus infinity to plus infinity, the delta of t is only defined at time t equal to 0 only. So at time t equal to 0, its value is 1. Now what is the value of this integration? The value of integration is obtained. So e power minus j omega t, you can evaluate this function only at time t equal to 0. Only at time t equal to 0. So other than the time t equal to 0, so the entire function is going to 0 because your delta of t is 0. So whenever you multiply 0 with any function, the value is 0. So you should get the value of the integration like this. Only we will get the value of this function at time t equal to 0. So at time t equal to 0, what is the value of this function? So it is simply equal to 1. It is simply equal to 1. That means what? The Fourier transform of your impulse function, unit impulse function, is what? 1. So that is your delta of j omega. So your delta of j omega is what? So it is equal to 1 value, unity value. So the Fourier transform of the unit impulse function is nothing but 1. So is nothing but 1. So I explained once again how to calculate the Fourier transform of this topic is based on the computation of the Fourier transform. So in this topic we are going to find out the Fourier transform of some standard signals. So in that I considered the first signal as the unit impulse signal. This is your first signal, unit impulse signal. So now what is the unit impulse signal? Already you know the unit impulse signal. It is only defined at time t equal to 0. So other than the time t equal to 0, its value is 0. So this is about the unit impulse signal. Now how can you find out the Fourier transform of the unit impulse signal? So you just use the formula of the Fourier transform. Now if we observe this integration, here the function e power minus j omega t is multiplied by delta of t. So whenever any function is multiplied by delta of t, you can get the value of the multiplication only at t equal to 0, So because your impulse is defined only at time t equal to 0, other than the time t equal to 0, your impulse is 0. So whenever you multiply any function with 0, the result is 0. Integration is nothing but accumulation of the function at a different instance of the time, minus infinity to plus infinity. So we are going to add the value of this multiplication. So at each and every instant from minus infinity to plus infinity, that is the meaning of the integration. So when you add from minus infinity to 0, you will get 0 value. Like that, from 0 to infinity, you will get 0 value. Only you will get the value of the function at time t equal to 0. But because at time t equal to 0, your delta of t is 1. So at time t equal to 0, what is the value of this function? E power 0. So e power 0 is what? So e power 0 is 1. So the Fourier transform of delta of t, which is your delta of j omega, is nothing but 1 value, This is your Fourier transform of the impulse, the unit impulse function, which is the value of 1. So this is your Fourier transform pair. Now I already told you, so in the introduction lecture, so the Fourier transform of the time domain signal results the signal in the frequency domain. So whenever the signal in the frequency domain, so it is having two components. One is the magnitude. So another one is the phase. So at an angle of delta of j omega. Now what is the magnitude? So the magnitude is nothing but 1. So 1 is the magnitude. So what is the phase? Phase is nothing but what? What is the phase of the function? So it is tan inverse of imaginary part is 0, real part is 1. So tan inverse of 0 is nothing but 0. So this is the phase is 0. So for all values of omega. So whenever the Fourier transform, if you apply the Fourier transform of the time domain signal, so you will get the signal in the frequency domain. So that is your delta of j omega. Now if you observe this signal, so this signal is a complex function in terms of the omega. So any complex function is having the magnitude and the phase. Now how can you plot the magnitude spectrum? So with respect to the magnitude spectrum. So the magnitude spectrum is nothing but the magnitude of your function. So that is your delta of j omega. So modulus of delta of j omega. So with respect to the magnitude spectrum is nothing but the plot of magnitude of delta of j omega, so versus omega, that is your magnitude spectrum. So with respect to omega, your magnitude is 1 for all values of the omega. So this is your magnitude spectrum. So this is the signal in the time domain, delta of t. Now what is the signal in the frequency domain? So this is the signal in the frequency domain. So for the signal in the frequency domain, we have two spectrums. I already explained two spectrums in the introduction part of the Fourier transform. One is your magnitude spectrum, another one is your phase spectrum. How can you plot the magnitude spectrum? Magnitude spectrum is nothing but the magnitude of delta of j omega versus the omega, versus the omega. That is your magnitude spectrum. So your magnitude spectrum is constant, that is one value. So because your delta of j omega is equal to 1, delta of j omega is equal to 1, this is your magnitude spectrum. Now how can you plot the phase spectrum? How can you plot the phase spectrum? So this is your phase spectrum. So at an angle of delta of j omega, so versus omega, is nothing but the phase spectrum. Here the phase spectrum is 0, because the angle is 0 for all values of the omega, phase spectrum is 0. So this is your phase spectrum. Phase spectrum. So in the examination, one signal is given to you. So for that signal, we need to develop the magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum. So the magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum, the collectively called as the frequency spectrum, is collectively called as the frequency spectrum. Both are called as the frequency spectrum. A spectrum is nothing but the frequencies, a collection of frequencies. So at each and every frequency, we are going to define the value of the function, or magnitude of the function, or phase of the function. That is nothing but the spectrum. Spectrum is nothing but the frequencies, which consists of the frequencies. At each and every frequency, we are going to define the magnitude of the function, or we are going to define the phase of the function. That is the meaning of the spectrum. So the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum, which are collectively called as the frequency spectrum, frequency spectrum. So this is about the Fourier transform of the impulse function, unit impulse signal. The Fourier transform of unit impulse signal is what? 1. So remember this expression. So this is very, very important expression. The Fourier transform of the unit impulse function is equal to 1. Or if the inverse Fourier transform of 1 is nothing but what? The unit impulse signal. This is the first standard signal. So next standard signal we are going to discuss these, the second signal. So almost we have 10 type of signals are there. We are going to calculate the Fourier transform of each and every standard signal. So because in the examination, so essay question is given on this topic. Find out the Fourier transform of the signum function, find out the Fourier transform of the unit impulse function, or find out the Fourier transform of the unit step function. Like that the essay questions came in the examination. Therefore, we are going to learn each and every standard signal, its corresponding Fourier transform. The second one is the one-sided. So the one-sided. So one-sided real exponential signal. So one-sided real exponential signal. So the next standard signal we are going to discuss is the one-sided real exponential signal. What is your problem? So last slide. Yes. Fourier transform of the unit impulse signal. Clearly observe here. You just use this formula. You can remember these two formulas, very, very important. Throughout the Fourier transform, these two formulas plays an important role. So using these two formulas only, we are going to learn each and everything. So in the process of computation of the Fourier transform of the standard signals, we also use this formula. So remember here, while discussing the Dirichlet's condition, I told you one point. So third point in the Dirichlet condition is what? So if you want to use this formula, so this Fourier transform formula, your signal x of t must be absolutely integrable. Your signal x of t must be absolutely integrable. So I told in the Dirichlet's conditions, the third condition of Dirichlet is what? So if you want to use this Fourier transform formula, if you want to find the frequency domain signal using this formula, here x of t must be absolutely integrable. That means if you integrate your signal from minus infinity to plus infinity, so you should get the finite value. So otherwise this formula is not valid. If you observe the unit impulse function, so if you integrate your unit impulse function, so delta of t dt, so you should get a value of 1, so that's why we are indicating here at time t equal to 0 it is represented by 1. This 1 is nothing but the area under the impulse function, so I told you these concepts in the case, while discussing the standard signals. So if you want to use this formula, the signal must be absolutely integrable signal, otherwise we cannot apply this formula. But I told you there in the case of Dirichlet's conditions, these Dirichlet's conditions are not necessary conditions, these are only sufficient conditions. So why? Because we still apply the Fourier transform even though some signals are not absolutely integrable signals. So we have some special signals are there. So for those signals, we still find out the Fourier transform not by using this formula, So we find out the Fourier transform of some special signals using a separate procedure, Therefore, the Dirichlet's conditions in that aspects are not necessary but sufficient conditions. So I told you in the case of Dirichlet's conditions, all the conditions. So why those conditions are not necessary and why those conditions are sufficient. So this is the Fourier transform of the unit impulse function. So next we will move on to the next standard signal. This is the one-sided real exponential signal. All of you clearly observe, this is a real exponential signal, one-sided real exponential signal. How can you define this signal? The one-sided real exponential signal is defined like this. So e power minus at into u of t. So this is the definition of this one-sided real exponential signal. Meaning of this signal is, so if you plot the graph of this x of t, so you can realize this, why we call this as the one-sided real exponential signal. So this is the time axis, so minus infinity and this is infinity. So this is your x of t. Now you multiply your e power minus at by u of t. U of t is what? This is the unit step function. So u of t is what? Unit step function. How can you define this u of t? So u of t is 1 for time t is greater than 0 and it is 0 for time t is less than 0. So for time t is less than 0, if you observe time t is less than 0 in this aspect, time t is less than 0, your u of t is 0. So when you multiply any function with u of t, for time t is less than 0, you should get 0 value. Here you should get 0 value only. The reason is your u of t is 0 for time t is less than 0. So if you multiply 0 with any value, you should get what? You should get 0 value. Your x of t is 0 for time t is less than 0 because your u of t is 0. Now your u of t is 1. For time t is greater than 0, so this is your time t is greater than 0, so this is your 1 at time t equal to 0, so this value is 1, so if you substitute t equal to 0 in this expression, you will get 1 value, and for time t is greater than 0, you multiply your e power minus at by 1, So let us clearly observe this function. Your x of t is 0, for time t is less than 0, because your u of t is 0. So if you multiply 0 with e power minus at, you should get a 0 value. And for time t is greater than 0, so you should get what? So you should get e power minus at. you should get e power minus at per time t is greater than 0. So per time t is greater than 0, so what is your x of t? E power minus at into u of t. Your u of t is what? 1. So 1 is multiplied by e power minus at for time t is greater than 0. Now how can you plot this e power minus at? This is your real exponential signal. As the t progressively increases on the right hand side, so what about this? E power minus at is nothing but e power 1 by e power at. So if t goes on increases, so your denominator goes on increases. So what about the result? So 1 by increment value. So this value is goes on decreases whenever the t is progressively increases. So and the plot of this curve is like this. So you should get a plot like this. So this is the plot of e power minus at into u of t. So this is nothing but the one-sided real exponential signal. This is your e power minus at into u of t. Here u of t is 1. So no need to write the u of t because it is 1 for time t is greater than 0. So as the t increases, your denominator goes on increases. Therefore, so 1 by denominator is there. So it decreases as the t progressively increases. So this is your one-sided real exponential signal. And I want to find out the Fourier transform of the one-sided real exponential signal. So in the examination, no signal is given to you. So just like they are asking like this. Find out the Fourier transform of the one-sided real exponential signal. Like that the question is given in the examination. So they are not giving the signal directly. They are asking indirectly. Find out the Fourier transform of the one-sided real exponential signal. Like that the question is given. So the Fourier transform of your one-sided real exponential signal is what? So e power minus at into u of t. So I want to find out the Fourier transform of this signal. So what is the formula? You just apply the formula. So integral minus infinity to plus infinity. So e power minus at, here the signal is u power minus at into u of t. E power minus j omega t dt. So this is the formula for the finding the Fourier transform. Now I just reduce my limits from minus infinity to plus infinity to like this. So if you consider minus infinity to 0, your u of t is 0. So no need to consider the minus infinity to 0 limits. So I can split this minus infinity to plus infinity like this. Minus infinity to 0 plus 0 to infinity. Like that I can split this integration limits minus infinity to plus infinity. So from minus infinity to 0, your u of t is 0. So no need to consider this limit. Only consider this limit 0 to infinity. So 0 to infinity I can write directly. So e power minus at. So your u of t is what? From 0 to infinity, u of t is 1 into e power minus j omega t dt. So this is the integration, the manipulation of the above equation. So integral 0 to infinity. So e power minus at into e power minus j omega t is what? So e power minus of a plus j omega times t dt. Now e power minus at dt is what? So e power, so if you don't know the integration, it is very difficult. So a power a plus j omega t divided by the t coefficient. Here the t coefficient is minus of a plus j omega. So you just remember this equation. So integral e power minus at dt is what? So e power minus at divided by minus a. You need to write the coefficient of t in the denominator. So that is the result of integral e power minus at dt. So which is your e power minus at by minus a. Now in the similar way, it is of the form e power minus at. So e power minus at divided by t coefficient is what? Here minus of a plus j omega. and you need to substitute the limits of the integration. So limits of the integration are 0 to infinity. Now if you find out the integral value, this here left out the minus 1 plus j omega outside. So you just substitute the upper limit. So whenever you substitute the upper limit, you just observe here minus, so a plus j omega, so this is infinity, minus e power minus of a plus j omega into 0. Now e power minus infinity is what? So e power minus infinity is what? So 1 by e power infinity. So e power infinity is what? Infinity. So 1 by infinity is what? 0. That means the first term is going to 0. Going to 0. Now what about the second term? So e power minus 0 is what? E power minus 0 is 1. E power minus 0 is 1. Here minus 1 is there. Here minus 1. So what is the final value of the result? 1 by a plus j omega. So this is the answer. This is the answer. So your Fourier transform of the one-sided real exponential signal. So is nothing but, so I can write the answer here, e power minus at, so into u of t. So its Fourier transform is nothing but 1 by a plus j omega. So this is your answer. This is your answer. So that is your x of j omega. That is your x of j omega. I can take x of t is e power minus at into u of t. So this is your x of j omega. So if I consider here, x of t is like this. This is your x of t. This is your x of j omega. This is your x of j omega. Now if you observe the x of j omega. So x of j omega is a complex valued function or not? So this is a complex valued function in terms of the omega. So every complex valued function is having both magnitude and the phase spectrum. Both magnitude and the phase spectrum. So all of you listen carefully here. This is a complex valued function. The frequency domain signal is a complex valued function in terms of the omega. So every complex valued function is having the magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum. So in the examination, like that the question is given. So develop the frequency spectrum for the time domain signal given to you. So that is x of t is given to you. So we need to develop the frequency spectrum for the time domain signal. For that we need to apply the Fourier transform on this time domain signal. So after applying the Fourier transform, so we find out the x of j omega. After find out the x of j omega, so using this x of j omega equation, we need to develop the magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum Now what is your x of j omega? How can you develop the magnitude and the phase spectrum? So your x of j omega, let us observe here, to develop the magnitude and the phase spectrum. So your x of j omega is nothing but 1 by a plus j omega. So this is the result I got from this. So e power minus a t into u of t. This is one-sided real exponential signal, because it is only defined on the positive side of the real axis. That's why it is called one-sided real exponential signal, not complex. This is the real exponential signal. So its Fourier transform is nothing but 1 by a plus j omega. So 1 by a plus j omega. So this is the x of j omega. So this is a complex valued function in terms of the omega. So every complex valued function is having the magnitude, that is your mod x of j omega, and is having the phase at an angle of x of j omega. So at an angle of x of j omega. Now how can you find out the magnitude spectrum? How can you find out the magnitude spectrum? So the magnitude spectrum is nothing but modulus of x of j omega versus omega. This is your magnitude spectrum. So this is your magnitude spectrum. So how can you find out mod x of j omega? So mod x of j omega is nothing but what? So 1 by mod a plus j omega. So 1 by mod a plus j omega is what? 1 by square root of, so a square plus omega square. So this is your mod x of j omega. So we need to plot the mod x of j omega versus omega. That is your magnitude spectrum. That is your magnitude spectrum. Here mod x of j omega. So what is its value? So 1 by square root of a square plus omega square. On the x axis we have omega value. Here omega is 0. So whenever omega is 0, you should get what? Modulus value is 1 by a. Modulus value is 1 by a. So whenever the omega increases, so its modulus value decreases in time. So like that we will get. So on the negative side of the omega axis also, so this is minus omega. So whenever the omega increases, so omega square value increases, and omega square is in the denominator, therefore the total value of the function decreases as the omega progressively increases. So like that we will get the magnitude spectrum. That is your magnitude spectrum. So this is your magnitude spectrum. Now how can you plot the phase spectrum? So how can you plot the phase spectrum? So phase spectrum is nothing but at an angle of x of j omega. So that is your phase. So versus omega is nothing but the phase spectrum. Spectrum is nothing but the frequencies, which consists of the frequencies. So for the corresponding frequencies, we define the phase of the function. That is our phase spectrum. Here in the magnitude spectrum, it is a collection of the frequencies. So at each and every frequency, we are going to define the magnitude of the function. That is your magnitude spectrum. Both the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum are collectively called as the frequency spectrum. So this is your phase spectrum. Now can you find out the phase? So to find out the phase, we need the real and imaginary parts. Of this expression. So how can you get the real and imaginary parts? You just rationalize the equation. So a minus j omega. Now how can we get x of j omega? So let us clearly observe, to get the real and imaginary parts, we just rationalize this expression. So a minus j omega, that is numerator. Denominator is a square plus omega square. Now your x of j omega is what? So a by a square plus omega square. So minus j into omega by a square plus omega square. So this is your imaginary part. This is your real part. Now what is at an angle of x of j omega? So it is nothing but the tan inverse of the imaginary part is what? So minus omega by a square plus omega square, that is your imaginary part. What is your real part? So a by a square plus omega square. Here a square plus omega square gets cancelled. Here we will get minus tan inverse of omega by a. So this is your phase. Now the plot of phase versus the frequency is nothing but what? The phase spectrum. So this is at an angle of x of j omega. So this is the real axis. So minus omega here. So omega here. So whenever the omega is 0, here we should get the 0 phase. And whenever the omega increases in this direction, so you should get the phase like this. So this is your phase spectrum plot. It is a plot between phase and omega. So that is your phase spectrum. So how can you find out the phase? To find out the phase, we need the real and imaginary parts of your frequency domain signal. How can you get the real and imaginary parts? You just rationalize this equation to get the real and imaginary parts, so that we will get the phase of the function. So this is about the Fourier transform of the one-sided real exponential signal. This is about the Fourier transform of the one-sided real exponential signal. So in the next class, we'll discuss the remaining standard signals in the next class. So I will stop today's class. Thank you all for joining the session. See you in the next class.